Chalkbeat is an award-winning nonprofit news organization dedicated to local education journalism.
Public schools are the heart of democracy in the sense that that's the place where we say everyone should have equal opportunity, everyone should have access to the same education. So I think it's kind of fundamental to the American promise.
We prioritize covering communities who are the most in need of what public education promises.
We really value the importance of providing a voice to the people that matter the most in the system. And the people that matter the most are not the administrators. They are not just school board members. They are the students, the parents who just want to ensure that their kids are getting a good education. So I grew up in Chicago, the daughter of a single mother who was a teacher. It never clicked in me growing up on the South Side, attending all black, low-income schools that was somehow, or that could somehow be a barrier for me. I felt leaving high school, given the grades that I got, I thought college is going to be a breeze. And I was struggling in every single class except for my English class. The one thing that drives me is it's been 30 plus years since I graduated high school, and not a lot has changed for people who come out of urban school districts like, you know, Chicago and Detroit. More people need to understand the struggles and the challenges facing these kids.
We have now 70 people on our team and we're growing fast.
Chalkbeat's funding model is very, very different. They have figured out a way to build local journalism based on philanthropy in a more sustainable and more stable way, I think, than just about anybody else.
And so how many of your students are even coming into school?
Oh, now? None.
Really?
Maybe one.
Joicky Floyd is a teacher in Newark and a parent. Her partner that she was separated from, but still very close to, ended up dying right around the time the pandemic began. Her kids were out of school, so she was trying to help them stay focused and doing their work. First time I actually met her was when I was writing about these students who had gone missing in the spring because they had to work, because they couldn't get connected to the internet. And so she was actually going and trying to track them down. And she would walk to students' houses because she doesn't have a car. And so she would go and knock on their doors and just ask, are you okay?
I just remember speaking to him that first time and just getting so much off my chest.
So after those first few days, then did you start teaching from home again?
Yeah, Mr. Wall's voice was life, right? Like his energy, I felt his energy. And it was like I needed that energy.
The Star Ledger newspaper ran our story on the front page, which got a lot of notice here. People reached out to her. Some people offered to help give things to her students that needed them.
I was ready to give up. I was tired. I was so tired. And then here he comes and turns everything around. 180 degrees.
The anticipation of it all was that it may not work.